Can you show us in the Quran where Jesus Christ comes back, where he breaks the cross, as you Muslims claim, where he kills the pig, and where he tells Christians, just show us
again,
from the Quran.
For the record of the camera,
I'm
surrounded by Christians here.
No, you're not. I'm not a Christian.
I'm a victim. I'm surrounded by Christians. And do not argue with the people of the scripture, except for those who commit injustice among them and say, we believe in that which has been revealed to us and revealed to you, and our God and your God is one, and we are Muslim. Wait, you believe our God is one?
We believe there's only one God.
Yeah, you keep on arguing. We've been trying to get to this point regarding the Quran.
Mm-hmm.
Why the Quran and why the message of the Quran contradicts so many messages or messengers in the Bible, so many prophets in the Bible. So at last, the bottom line, this is what we came down to. This is my last question.
Yeah.
When Jesus Christ comes back, we Christians believe it. It's in our Bible. It's explicitly written. Yeah. It's implicitly implied.
Mm. Yeah.
In the Quran, Muslims have this believing also that Jesus Christ is coming back. Yeah. So I clarified that. I said, listen, you believe he's coming back. And when he comes back, he's going to do A, B, B, C, C. He's going to do so and so and so. So I'm asking, I'm saying, can you show me these verses in the Quran where Jesus is going to do all these things that you Muslims claim? Now, all of a sudden, when he realizes, he stands there for 10 minutes looking for the verse. When he realizes he can't find the verse, he finds a verse, he reads the verse he now finds, and then he tells me that this is the question I asked, and now the question has been changed.
Listen.
Madness.
He wants to use that example, but how about when you ask me to find a verse where it says that Jews and Christians corrupted the book, and I showed you several verses, and then you try to move on to try to be like, no.
This
is not the first time you've done that, bro.
Yeah,
it's not the first time you've done that.
Yeah, but the Quran
also says
that
it's not the first time you've done that. You changed your tune as well.
Hold on, but it says that Allah favors the Israelites.
So wait, hold on. So hold on, Gary, what's going on here? Are you neutral? Are you trying to hear both our arguments?
No,
or are you trying to side with him and then try to pose me questions? Because I haven't heard you ask him anything.
I'm just asking you as a Muslim.
Come on, bro.
You as a Muslim, you have a belief.
I'm ready.
You as a Muslim, you believe into Jesus Christ coming back.
Yes.
You believe that when he comes back, he's going to break the cross.
Gary, do you want me to keep you the bottom line of everything?
Wait, just be quiet for a second, brother.
All this talk is long. I'll give you the bottom line of everything.
You don't have
even
it in your Bible.
Even if that is the situation.
What's the situation?
What's in the Bible is different from God contradicts in the Quran.
That's not what we're talking about.
Okay, no. But that was your initial point.
What's what we're talking about? Why don't you let me finish what I'm saying and then you respond?
Because it's gonna avoid this whole confusion. Try to take the piss out of me all you want.
There ain't no Mickey taking here, bro.
Okay, watch this. No. Let me just finish the point I'm making, yeah?
There ain't no Mickey taking.
The initial point you made, you was trying to
There's
say,
just
the
you
point you was making.
Speaking, Aki, squeaking, brothers, squawking.
Just, okay, cool.
And all we want to do is basically get to the bottom line. The bottom line is, can you show us in the Quran where Jesus Christ comes back, where he breaks the cross, as you Muslims claim, where he kills the pig, and where he tells Christians, just show us
again,
from the Quran.
The
this was the initial
again,
question.
He moves the goalposts. Gary, please let me just finish. I'm saying one thing.
Now, the reason why we asked this question. I know he hasn't got it. I know.
Because
in the.
I just want to
make this one. The reason why we asked this question.
Yeah, the whole reason why he brought this question.
Sorry, brother.
He's trying to say that the Bible, the God of the Bible, is different to the God of the Quran. The God of the Quran contradicts into what he contradicts what the God of the Bible says. This is his initial point, and he reiterated that to you when he first came here, yeah? I'm saying now, even if that is the case, so what? Us as Muslims, we see the Quran as a knowledgeable high point. We see that as the authority. So even if they do contradict, we know it came to confirm and to correct what came before.
Here's the problem.
Yeah,
how can something affirm and confirm something that's contradictory?
The Quran says to you to go to the people of the book.
Yeah.
for clarification.
Okay, cool.
So the Bible's corrected, corrected. Why would
you come to me?
Go back to the man of the
my book, and yet your book is now. You're just saying that my book is corrupted.
Can I explain?
Madness.
Are you going to interrupt me?
No, no, no. I'm just saying. That's what it says in the Quran.
So in the Quran it says, "Go to if you're in doubt, go to the people of the book."
Yes.
Who's it talking to?
It's talking to Jews and Christians.
No, no, but who's in that verse? Who's he talking to?
He's talking to Jews and Christians.
No, but who is the verse addressing?
I'm saying to you.
He's talking to Muhammad.
Yeah.
Okay. No, he's talking to Muhammad. It's saying to Muhammad, if you're in doubt, go to the people of the book.
Yeah, the Jews and the Christians.
Okay, cool.
Yes.
What did Muhammad do when he came down? Yeah. Okay, cool. When he came down from Mount Hira, what was the first thing he done?
What did he do?
He went to his wife, and where did him and his wife go? Khadija, where did they go? They went to Waraqah bin Nawfal.
Yeah,
who's
Waraqah
bin Nawfal?
And the story, he was a Christian.
He's a person of Allah.
He's an historian, not a Christian.
He was
an historian.
Okay, cool. So he was in doubt. He went to the people of the book, and he said, had I been alive any longer, I'd probably...
Yeah, but why is that? Yeah, but how could a book be corrupted?
If you have to come, if you have to affirm my book,
it don't make any sense.
Okay. Allah was telling him to go to the people. And he also done that in Yathrib as well.
Allah
he
went never to the spoke people to
Muhammad. And they said, and they said, you are the
Muhammad. Never.
They confirmed.
Never.
That's why some of the biggest rabbis of Yathrib.
It was an angel. It was an angel who met
some of the biggest rabbis.
Muhammad in the cave.
But see, not even listening to what I'm saying. He asked me a question. He doesn't want to hear what I'm saying.
Because my question is nothing. You're not answering my question. You're not dealing with Gary's question.
My question, which is one of the main guys that converted Islam, he kept his Kabbalist faith, his Judaic faith.
I don't know if you want to talk about the name of rabbis.
We're talking about, he
was one of the leading rabbis of Yathrib. Medina at the time had several Jewish tribes, Ben Nadir, Ben Qurayza, these people here. He was one of the main rabbis at the time, and he came to Islam. So he went to the people of the book. He was unsure. They said
but it still say you must go. To the Jews and Christians.
He was unsure of whether he was of what was going on in the cave at the time. So that's why he went there, and he went to the people of the book, and they confirmed it.
Now you're
saying go to the people of the book.
Go to the people of the book. It says it.
So you're saying okay. So you're saying I should go to the people of the book.
Yes, you have to go to him.
Okay, show me.
I'm just going where it says. I'm being unbiased. I'm just going to go in doubt with the Quran.
Look, for the record of the camera,
I'm just saying what it says.
But I'm surrounded by Christians here.
No, I'm not Christian.
I'm a victim. I'm surrounded by Christians.
I'm not Christian.
The point I'm making is here.
What are we going to do?
I'm surrounded by.
No, you're not.
By.
No, I'm not.
Listen to what I'm saying. I'm surrounded by people who oppose what I believe. I just put forward an explanation. Listen to what I'm saying. You've been doing this for the last hour and a half, bro. Keep interrupting me. I just put forward an explanation of what I said, and no one wants to accept it.
No, but here it is. Watch it.
Brother, you're just showing me a screenshot.
No, I'm just showing you.
Okay, now, and what does that say in brackets?
No, in brackets.
No.
What does that say?
What does that say?
Oh,
Muhammad. So who is he talking to? Muhammad. What did Muhammad do? He went to the people.
Listen to what we are saying to you. Do you listen to what's been said to you?
Right, listen. The mic's going to come out. Listen.
The big guns.
Now you and I know in Arabic, whenever you see a word in brackets, it's not confirmed in Arabic.
Okay, yeah, so
it's not confirmed in Arabic. Because when you go to Yusuf Ali, it doesn't say Muhammad.
But then, okay, cool.
It just says, when in doubt, go to the
camera. Because you don't want
to
show the camera. You don't want to show the camera. Look, okay, cool. What's this?
I can show you.
So every single Every single translation, with the exception of Yusuf Ali, it says, "Oh, Muhammad," in brackets.
Yes.
So who is it addressing?
No, but listen, now watch.
Exactly.
Now watch.
So what's the point? Like I said, I'm surrounded by opposers of Islam.
Now, would you like to see magic? Watch this now. Now, we know.
Watch the evidence.
When in doubt, watch this now. We have to go tafsir to understand what it means. Janelain, let's go. Now, he said, "You, oh Muhammad." Okay, we talked to Muhammad. There's a confirmation.
Yeah.
You see, tafsir. When in doubt concerning what revealed to you in stories, hypothetically speaking, then question those that read the scripture, the Torah, right?
Hypothetically speaking.
Now, when we go
No, bro, these are screenshots. What? Click on Tafsir. Go to Tafsir Ibn Kathir on the same verse.
Wait, okay, cool.
But go to Tafsir Ibn Kathir
on the same verse. I'm finished.
Picking and choosing. These men are like journalists. I swear down, these are like journalists.
Yo, man.
I know, look, he's prepared. He's got screenshots on his phone. It's not even internet.
Hold on, watch this. Watch this here.
Serious.
Do not argue with people of the scripture in such a way.
Don't argue with me. Don't argue with me.
Now, in the Tafsir, it says, It says here, do not argue with people of the scripture, right?
Let me take a picture.
I'm finished. Except those that in the best way. You must argue with these guys.
Don't argue with me.
Now, when you listen to Ibn Abbas, what he says, do not argue with people of the scripture, the Jews and the Christians.
I'll just like to point out.
Don't argue with people.
Have you noticed how Gary came through as a neutral person? He came to hear both sides of the argument. And all of a sudden, this guy is such a victim.
Oh my gosh!
He's turned around and he's got screenshots on his phone.
I've already had it here already. He wants a friend. That's why it's called iPad.
I know, phone a friend, brother.
That's why it's called iPad.
Not phone a friend, because everything I've said can be substantiated.
No, nothing you said. Nothing you squeaked. Nothing you squawked.
Okay, for the sake of the camera, ask these men all along. For the sake of the camera, they asked me. It says, if you're in doubt, go to the people of the book.
Don't argue with people.
Yo, I said that's about Muhammad, and he went to the people of the book.
Have you argued
with me? They just showed me several translations where it said, oh, Muhammad. So my point was confirmed. So but they want to look away. They want to take away and start trying to show me translations. See, look, even you. Come on,
bro. Let's read it
now. And do not argue. Oh, yo, where's my man?
Let's give it first. What's it? Surah 29:46. Read it.
And do not argue with the people of the scripture except in a way that is best. Except for those who commit injustice among them and say, we believe in that which has been revealed to us and revealed to you, and our God and your God is one, and we are Muslim. Wait, you believe our God is one?
We believe there's only one God.
Yeah, you keep on arguing with me?
Yeah.
How dare you argue with us?
Exactly.
How dare you? What's going on?
Your God is one.
This is nuts.
You and his God
are
one.
This is nuts.
Are you ever going to argue with me again?
This is nuts.
No. And look, to confirm it, Tafsir.
Are you saying your God is one? Are you saying your God is one? Are you saying your God is one?
God is one.
So you don't believe that in the Trinity?
God is one.
But do you believe in the Trinity?
Hold on. Let's just do this. God, hear, O Israel, Jehovah your God is one. Mark chapter 6, Deuteronomy chapter 6.
Okay, cool.
Now what?
Okay, cool. So God is one.
Whoa! Okay. Are you arguing with me?
No, I'm asking you a question.
Are you arguing with me?
So wait, hold on. Because you lot can all laugh at me.
But it says
I'm wrong. No, because you lot all laughing at me.
Brother, no one's laughing at you.
No, you are.
We're telling you your words. We're telling you your book.
You are.
Don't argue with us.
Don't argue with them.
Okay, cool.
Except that is the way they
play. Are you arguing with me?
Okay, cool. Clearly, I'm not arguing with you lot because clearly I cannot win because I'm trying to talk.
No,
I'm
not. You're not arguing.
I'm trying to talk from truth.
You can argue with Gary.
I'm trying to talk from truth and truth.
Yeah, you can argue with me.
You can argue. Gary,
they want to laugh.
You can argue with
listen, you can argue with Gary.
I can't even.
You can argue with Gary.
Yeah, because I'm not a Christian. But these Christian guys.
But you can't argue
boys.
With us.
They're bad boys. You have to leave
can I read the verse?
Yeah, read it aloud. And you can read whichever version you want.
Look, and do not argue with the people of the scripture.
Say again. One more time.
Except. Listen to the word. Except. So there's a. There is an exception where I can't argue.
Yeah, what's the exception?
For the way that is best, and except for those, so another exception, who commit injustice among them.
Okay. Yeah, go on. Yeah, okay, cool.
Point the camera at this guy.
Injustice.
Praise the Lord, Jesus is Lord.
I say, and say.
You're arguing again.
Okay, cool. And me say, we believe in which has been revealed to us and what has been revealed to you, that our God and your God is one.
Yeah, exactly.
So that's what I've been saying since the beginning. But you've not misunderstood it. You thought that he's saying that your God is one.
You're squealing again.
Okay, cool. That's what I'm trying to say. This is what I'm trying to say.
iPad.
Every time that I make a just point, every time I make a valid point, there's
around.
No more substance. It's quite dominant. Yeah, you're squealing. You're doing this. You don't know what you're talking about.
Here.
I can't hear
Hello.
You. But bro,
the
substance.
Everybody,
is, no,
I just
but
want
I'm talking.
You to understand
I'm talking
something,
to the audience because you lot are all just heckling.
I want you to understand something.
When Gary came here. Gary came here as a neutral person.
Just a second. Yo. Stop trying to justify yourself.
Come on, Gary.
When Gary came here. The question was very simple.
I'm gonna phone a friend.
The question was very simple.
You better get yourself an iPad.
Hey, Sammy.
The question was very simple.
Come.
Where do Muslims get their believing that Jesus Christ is gonna come back? When he comes back, he's gonna kill the pig, break the cross. He's gonna tell Christians, who told you?
Okay.
We kept on asking this man here.
Let me ask
Can you show us this in the Quran?
Oh, let me ask you, you're not allowed to argue.
Oh yeah.
Where in the Bible does it say, in the Quran does it say what Jesus will do when he comes back?
You're not allowed to argue with him.
No, you can argue with him.
You don't understand the verse.
What's going
on here? Clearly, you don't understand. These men are ill. That's exactly what's going on.
This is why we have to disagree with your Quran. Go back to the verse.
Everything you're talking about is just an opinion.
You said I can't argue with a guy, so go back to the verse.
No, but can we go tafsir to get the meaning?
Okay, cool. But can we go to tafsir on my choosing? Not a screenshot, that's yours?
No, this is the Quran.
Can you see what I'm talking about, Sammy? These men are like journalists, bro. They got a man on a hot seat and they already got pictures and stuff from before.
No, you feel. Listen,
it's not happening. This verse changed the story about three times. This one here changed the story about three times.
I can't help it.
He came as a neutral person to both sides of the story.
This is what they call a Muslim. You are true to your ilk, brother.
Right.
You are true Muslim.
Okay, cool. Gary, let me read it.
Let me read it.
You're telling me I can't argue with the guy.
Now read the chapter from Ibn Abbas. What's it say?
Okay, cool. Can I read it?
Yeah, read it aloud. No, Ibn Abbas.
Okay, cool. Let me read the verse and then I'll read the tafsir.
Yeah, go on. Read the verse and then read the tafsir.
Okay, cool. The verse is, verse 29, 45.
Yes.
And do not argue with the people of the scripture.
That's me.
Except in a way that is, you know what except means?
No, don't argue with us.
There's an exception.
You're arguing again.
So I'm allowed to argue with you.
You're arguing right now.
With exception.
You're arguing right now.
In a way that is best, and except for those of you who commit injustice, this Donnie here, among them, and say, we believe in which has been revealed to us and which has been revealed to
you. Can
you
read that?
Our God and your God is one. We are Muslims and we submit to him.
Okay, calm down.
Sammy, you was here from Kabbalah. You was here from earlier. What was I saying to him? I was saying that the Bible, the God of the Bible is the same as God of the Quran. He disputed that. So I'm allowed to argue with him. So what's Gary talking about?
Can you read the next one?
He's talking trash. You know what I'm saying? Because I could come down to their level and start being rude as well.
He just makes things up as he goes along.
I just showed the verse.
As you go along, you just make things up as you go along. Anyway, don't argue with me.
Wait a second.
So you don't argue with me. Is that what's going on?
Alright, watch this now.
You can't argue
with me. Did I beat the will out of you?
Now you read the tafsir.
Huh?
Which was the tafsir?
That's the tafsir.
So wait, what's the verse?
Ibn Abbas. Okay. Of Ibn Abbas. Your top scholar. Go and read what it says.
And argue. This is in brackets. And argue not with the people of the scripture. But Jews and Christians.
Are you Jewish?
Did you get it? Unless it be in a way that is better, i.e. example, by the Quran, brackets, save with such of them as do wrong, close brackets, from among the delegation, should I read on?
The key note is there, the punchline is there, don't argue with the bad boys, the Jews and the Christians.
I just gave you two exceptions.
You're breaking your Quran.
Don't argue with them.
Where is this going? Is this what's happening?
These are the bouncers.
Is this what's happening? What happened to the substance? What happened to the substance of the debate? What happened to the substance? These men are lost.
Muhammad comes along 700 years after
you
Jesus Christ.
In the actual verse, it said, in the verse Muhammad itself, I don't have to go to no tafsir. It says there's two exceptions where I could argue with them. But I don't know how it even got to this. How did this conversation get here?
Okay, watch this now.
Gary, I'm asking something. Surah 2, these men are arguing for the sake of arguing. This is Allah speaking. I'm here by myself. I'm thinking, Abu Ahad, allies. Two teachers are getting stabbed in the back. Surah 1 saying that Israel is regarded as his people.
Above all the people on the face of the earth. This is Allah speaking.
Okay, so then why
is everybody Muslim then? You should be all Israelites.
So there's no problem with that. You all should be Israelites.
But how can you have somebody above everybody else on the planet?
Listen to what you're saying. You're saying why we all Muslims and we should be Israelites. Do you realize Israelite is a race? Do you know that, yeah?
It's a people. Yes, it's a race of people.
So how can everyone be Israelites, bro? How about the people in Africa? Okay. How about the people in South America? So what are you talking about, bro?
The 12 tribes of Israel, but...
So what are you talking about? Come on.
Exactly. No, hold on a second.
I tell you,
when you come to Israelite and ask them for permission.
How? What was wrong with what I just said?
Everything you say is mediocre.
What was wrong?
Everything you say is mediocre.
He just asked me why we are not all Israelites.
But from the very beginning, you've been trying to deal with just you trying to find verses in your Quran that suggest that
can we find a common ground? Wait. What's your name, brother? I don't even know your name.
Yo, man, you can't ask me your name an hour and a half to 2 hours later.
I'm Adam. What's your name?
Right.
My name's Adam. What's your name?
If I was an Israelite,
I'm trying to shake his hand. He doesn't want to shake my hand. I introduce myself to him. He doesn't want to.
Brother,
what was wrong with what I just said to him? He just said that we should all be Israelites. How can we all be Israelites?
Don't argue with me.
It's like me saying...
You're arguing with me again.
Don't argue with me. Don't argue with us.
So then...
I like it.
So why are you...
You know, it's funny because when you mentioned that,
you don't want to argue with me. Why are you asking me questions?
You have to subdue yourself when I tell you that.
Why do you want to...
You know why?
Because this is in your book now. If you don't want to argue with me, why are you asking me questions?
No one's asking you anything.
You did.
We're telling you something.
You just asked me questions.
We're telling you something. That's the difference. We're telling you.
Okay then, bro.
We're telling you. We're telling you from the very beginning.
We're helping you out.
So what now? Kevin Hart, so what now?
We're helping you out.
So what now?
We're helping you out.
So what now, bro? So what now?
The Bible says they should kill you. No.
But brother, the thing is, everything they've asked, I've answered.
There are verses in the Quran that tell that Muslims will be punished if they don't believe in the Bible.
Right, read it now before it goes.
Surah chapter 2, 1, 2, 2. Surah 2, 1, 2, 2. Oh, children of Israel. Children of Israel,
before the battery goes.
Remember my favor which I have bestowed upon you, and that I preferred you upon the world.
That's it. Wow. Allah talking about
Israel. I have preferred you.
So you see, didn't prefer Muslims.
He didn't prefer you.
Oh,
who would not seek the Lord?
And if you want to clarify,
can I answer?
Game over, man. Game over.
No. Why can't I answer?
No, Tafsir.
Oh, children.
Tafsir confirmation.
Oh, children of Israel, remember my favor wherewith I favored you, and that I have preferred you over all the worlds. A similar verse has already been mentioned.
So Allah prefers Israelites, not Muslims.
Does Allah prefer Israelites or Muslims?
Israelites prefer Muslims.
Can I answer?
What's going on here?
Can I answer?
Allah has a preference.
Can I answer, yeah? Okay, are you not going to interrupt me for answer?
No. Unless you're using tafsir and Quran.
Gary, why do you want to interrupt Christians? Because you said you're not a Christian, isn't
that? I'm going to break it down for you. I'm not going to address him. Even though he's reading the book, I'm not going to address him.
You can't argue with me. That's why. That's right.
But I'm not going to address him.
Just glad that you know this. If he said that, you know this.
You're an Israelite, right?
There's 2 points.
I'm an Israelite.
Yeah, you're
Israelite.
This is top jaw here.
Okay, cool.
This is top jaw.
I'm the one that's... Your Allah is talking about me.
Let me know when you're ready to let me answer.
Yo,
let me know when you're ready to let me answer.
For 20 minutes, non-stop.
Let me know when you're ready to let me answer.
Okay. Let him answer now.
Okay, cool.
So,
O children of Israel.
Let's read it aloud. Read it aloud again.
No, he's right.
Let's listen again.
No.
Would you like to read it?
No.
Would you like to read it?
No, because he put it on his iPad.
Oh, my iPad? Are you listening to this?
He's read it many times.
Oh, these guys don't want to give me the knowledge.
Oh, children of Israel. Children of Israel, remember my favor which I have bestowed upon you, and that I preferred you.
Prefer who?
You. No. Oh, children of Israel! Remember my favor which I bestowed upon you, and that I preferred you over the world.
Okay, cool. Wow. Can I answer? Am I allowed to answer now?
Right, everybody, a Muslim.
Okay, cool. Am I allowed to answer now? Okay, can I answer now? Can I answer?
Not really.
We have 2 points in so much.
I don't know.
Okay, cool.
Why do Christians hate everybody? Because Bible says you should kill anybody who doesn't believe in Jesus.
God
is saying
this.
It's not saying we favored. No.
Yeah, God is saying this.
God is saying we.
Yeah, God.
Gary, can I answer?
Allah, the only one.
Can I answer the question?
In previous surahs and
that, it says we. Answer
that.
So there's 2 issues that we have to look at.
And now is I.
There's 2 issues you have to look at. Number 1, who are the children of Israel? And number 2, why? How is God getting their favor? He's not listening. He's not listening. So what? You ask me a question, you don't want to hear the answer.
But when I leave, there's no more arguing.
So you're not sincere.
When I leave, this conversation is over.
I don't know why I'm having this conversation. These men aren't sincere. They don't want to know the truth. They don't want to know the truth. Okay, cool. I'm just going to break it down real quick.
You can't run away like every Sunday. Come on.
Come here,
we've been asking for a while.
It's fine. I can hear you.
This guy.
been asking her for 1 hour.
This guy's a fan.
Gary, use a megaphone here. Yeah, I learned from you how to use a megaphone.
Come on, sign it. Where is it? I've got a pen here. Want me to sign it?
That dildo speaker.
Can I please answer the
dildo speaker.
Oh, you want this?
Bro, oh, sorry.
Is it a dildo? Oh, sorry.
Bro, can I answer the question?
That's a lot of money, man. That's a lot of money.
Can we get back to the topic?
No, it's the wrong shape. Can we get back to the topic? Going in.
This is so stupid. This is so stupid. Wallah, this is so stupid. Brother, can we get back to the topic?
It's going to be very painful going in. Needs to be rounded.
So you tried it last night. You knew it was painful.
Oh, thank you, mate.
Okay, cool. Can we get back to the topic? Can I answer the question? Okay, cool. There's two issues here.
Oh,
number one, the children of Israel.
He knows all about the gel. He needs gel, does he?
Oh, he's a pro, man.
Wow, he knows all about the gel.
Gary.
You can't fit in. Wow, Gary. Mate. There's some admission Gary. Going on here.
Gary.
Soho, man.
Okay, you know
Gary,
what?
You asked the question.
That is a cue to go home.
Gary, you asked the question.
When you see 5-0
you asked the question. See that? These men aren't sincere. These men are short.
One last point.
Okay, you asked the question, so let me answer it, yeah?
I just had deja vu, you know. We've done this before.
Okay, good. We've done this like 4 times. And you lot keep going on point.
I just want you to say one last thing.
Okay, let me answer the question.
From the very beginning, we've been asking the Muslims concerning Jesus Christ coming back, where
and
Jesus Christ is going to break the cross, where Jesus Christ is going to tell the Christians you worship me, where Jesus Christ is going to kill the pig. We've been asking Muslims, where do you substantiate this from your Quran? They have been unable to produce it, unable to show it, and each time they've come, they've weaseled their way, and then now they're basically trying to say that we've been asking different questions. The bottom line is this. They have a belief which does not come from their Quran. So when you ask them, where do you get this from? Where do you get this from? It's from their hadith. But their hadith comes 200 years after their Quran. 200 year plus after their Quran. So again, we keep on asking them, is the hadith divine? Is the hadith man-made? That's it.
Okay, cool. And can I answer the question, please, now that you asked the second
question? All right, we're going now. Listen, the argument's done.
Okay, cool.
Next week,
forget all of this. You men are jokers, bro. But look, it's as simple as this, yeah? It's as simple as this, bro, yeah? Cool. They asked about the children of Israel. Why were the children of Israel favored? Yeah? Or that light is proper bright now. Why are the children of Israel favored and now they no longer are? He says, so why is everyone Muslim and why are we not all Israelites? That's such a stupid question in itself because Islam is a religion, Israelite is a race. That means you came from Israel, you came from Jacob. So how can you ask the question, why isn't everyone Israelites? That's such a dumb question in itself. What about the people in Africa? What about the people in South America? What about the people in North America? They're not Israelites. So what? Are they to be forsaken? That doesn't sound right. It doesn't sound just. And secondly, exactly, bro. These men are jokers, bro. Secondly, yeah. We know from Surah Al-Fatiha, yeah, the verse that says, "Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, sirat al-ladina an'amta 'alayhim, ghayr al-maghdubi 'alayhim wal-dhalin." Amin. Yeah. Give us the straight path, not the path of those who have been led astray or gained your anger. Who are the people that's gained the anger? Was the Israelites. This is not just in the Quran. We know this from even Orthodox Jews say this themselves. They say they're not supposed to be in Israel right now because they're not going to go back to the promised land until fulfillment of their Messiah comes. So there you have it. Those are the points I was trying to make. Every point that I've asked, every question that they've asked. No, I have to say my piece, bro, because these men were proper gay men. They'll get under my skin. There was like 8 of them surrounding me. I thought some of them were on my side and they weren't, yeah? Okay, cool. But look, it's like this. Every question that they asked, I answered, but yet they wormed their way around it and they moved the goalposts. He asked me, where does it say in the Quran that Jesus is going to come back down for a second coming? I showed him. When I showed him, he tried to say, no, that's not what I asked you. I asked you, where does it say he's going to come down and break the sticks, or break the crosses and kill the pigs and all this and that? That's not what he asked. You could check on Titans TV, Kalem's channel. It was there, like, there's nothing more for me to say. You could clearly see that every question that they asked me are answered. When I answered, they replied back with ad hominem arguments. I'm out.